and welcome to Cosplayers Chat about Miraculous Ladybug. Today, we are going to be unboxing some Miraculous Ladybug figures that we treated ourselves to as an early Christmas present. This video is not sponsored, however, you can use our affiliate links down in the description to buy these products. Using the affiliate link will have no additional charge for you, but we may receive some commission. I am Hilda Glitz, I play Chloe in the 86th Floor Cosplay Music videos.
I'm Rascal Rabbit, I play Adrian in Cat Noir.
I'm Lou Manara, I play Marinette and Ladybug.
All right, let's grab our boxes, gang.
Grab our boxes.
We're gonna start with Miss Ladybug. So we got-
Miss Bug.
I'm just gonna do a quick itinerary for the folks at home. So we've got this Ladybug figurine here. Then we have Mr. Cat Noir. We have Lady Noir and Mr. Bug. So we're gonna start with Ladybug. This is the first one.
And I need adult supervision.
Free her.
Which sounds like a joke, but genuinely, I think.
Free her. She's out! She's free!
Oh my god!
Okay, I freed her. She's out. She's here.
She is she posable? I guess she's not.
Right,
she just,
she's posable
she
with one leg.
Okay.
Okay, queen.
Her legs are so long.
Well, that's fair enough. She has got long legs. She can pose one leg and one arm.
Oh, hell
so,
yeah.
So she's definitely very much, like, if you want, like, a posable Ladybug figure, this is probably not the one for you.
Okay.
Where do I sound the zip line?
Wait, what are you doing?
What are those? I do not see it. I look away. She comes with a yo-yo zip wire thing.
I have decided to release her.
Free her.
She's so pretty.
She is pretty. Actually, what, that's what I will say. Like, I was too busy. Like, I really, really love her.
I love her hair.
Oh. Oh. She's doing the cat. Oh. How did you do that?
I love her. You know what? I want to make her a display stand. I want to have her in like a little case. She's pretty.
I like her. Oh, look. Now she is connected. Oh,
she's
look.
Connected.
Wait. Here you go. Here we go.
Whoa.
Does she spin though?
No, I don't think she does.
No, what are you doing? No, that's giving me so much anxiety. That's not how it was intended to be played with. Oh, this is just, there are too many hazards involved with this thing, I think.
There's a lot of hazards. Yeah, her legs are pointy. There's a string. Like, there's little clippy things.
She can move
thing.
Her head too, a little bit.
Momo, stop! What I will say is that the zip line action is not particularly smooth. Look at this. It works if you go at a steeper angle. Or not. Okay, never mind. If you had to give this experience a rating out of 5,
how many miraculouses out of
how many?
Five, like?
The quality of the toy is excellent.
She's gorgeous. Can we
she
talk
looks
about
great. The pigtails are beautiful. The molding's really lovely. I would say though that I think in terms of play value, just thinking back to the kind of thing I would have wanted when I was a bit younger, I feel like it would. The kind of lack of posability in anything that isn't the other arm.
She can absolutely like go down the zip line and then just like kick all your other toys. Like,
yeah, I feel like if she was entirely posable, it'd be better. But I think this is a solid 4 out of 5.
The trouble is, like, she's really pretty, and I wish that maybe she just wasn't posable here, so she was just like a figure.
I do like the high kick though. She does stick her leggy out far.
It's sort of like you can have this hanging up, and then you can, if you get a bit bored. Leg version.
I also quite like how, if you look closely, she's got a little smirk going on.
So this was the Zipline Ladybug toy from Bandai, and the link is down in our description.
What if I
if
just
this
have her in the background
for you.
Of all the videos? I would give it a solid 3.
A solid 3, okay. I went for a 4 just because I felt like...
I'm going for a 4.
I enjoyed it quite
like,
a lot.
The functionality is not good, but it's so ridiculous that it's sort of like...
It's fun, yeah.
You know what? Fine, I'll give it a 4. I feel like
4.
three
4 out of 5 for that one. So we're gonna move on to your boy.
My boy.
We're gonna go for Cat Noir. I have a point to prove, actually. We get a lot of comments on our cosplay music videos telling us that we've spelt Cat Noir wrong. Look at it here, Chat Noir, because that's the French, isn't it? I mean, it also says Cat Noir because, like, you know, it's English, isn't it? I'm breaking it open with my fists. So this is a poseable one, and actually this is what I thought we were getting with the Ladybug, but
I've heard
we're
good
not.
Things about the poseability of this.
Yeah, okay, here he is. Oh, he's quite get him out carefully because he's quite entangled. So we have, you have Cat Noir himself. Oh, he's got a little staff, but it doesn't extend. It's very small, so just choking hazard, you know?
His tail is stuck.
I don't like his feet.
Oh. Oh no, but his feet are posable.
Why is it like that? No, you're so right.
Why did I do this?
Oh no.
No, no, but you can...
Is your foot okay?
The posability is actually brilliant.
There's so much posability in his feet, and I'm not sure
what. What I will say is I'm...
All this posability in his feet, and where's the wrist posability?
And what I do not like is his staff, because in my version, his look like, at that. His staff is bent.
I wish the tail was posable.
Yeah, it's frustrating that the tail is, and it's frustrating that the tail doesn't come off either.
In like I like that you can have him sitting down. So
however,
like,
he is quite graceful.
Look,
he do be sitting though. Hang on a minute. Look, we can
this
now have
it. It's quite cute to have at the office. You know,
Wait, I wonder if I bring back Miss Ladybug from over here. Oh no, he's quite small in comparison to her. Oh no, oh no. This feels like the kind of thing that you get a lot of play value out of. Like it feels like the kind of thing you would have.
It's something you could like chuck against the wall and it would be absolutely fine.
So what do we think on the rating, gang? I feel like actually for this one, I feel like just because I am so saddened with this staff and then the lack of posability in the tail, I think maybe it's a 3 for me.
Yeah. I would give him a 3. I think he looks like Cat Noir. He's cute. He's got like an obscene amount of posability in his feet. I can't actually tell you. There must be like, how many joints are in here? There's like 6 different pivot points just for like various stages of
He can point his feet though.
So you can, if your game involves Cat Noir breaking his ankle. Cat Noir, are you good? And he's like, no, man, my foot's not supposed to bend that way. And that's
I'm just going to try and add him to my tableau that I'm building back
your
here.
Your tableau!
I'm gonna give him a 4, because I think he's a good size and he's really poseable and there's some great detail. But I did talk to point because he's a bit cursed, like the tiny hands and the ankles. I'm a bit uncomfortable.
Yeah, but is Cat Noir not just a little bit cursed as like?
Yeah, but this is a different kind of cursed. I'm familiar with Cat.
He does have quite a lot of arm posability. Like I'm finding finding new.
There we go. He's been added to my tableau. So now we're into the Kwame Swap ones, and I feel like these are all now. The Ladybug one was an outlier, but these are all kind of from the same line. So if we go on to Lady Noir now, right? Okay, we have another staff sin because obviously this is technically another Cat Noir outfit. Another sad bent staff, which I'm not here for. She's less poseable than Cat Noir is. She also doesn't come with another, because Cat Noir came with like 2 staffs. Like he came with like the phone version and the main version, but she only comes with 1.
I feel like I need another little accessory.
Also, I am gutted that her plait doesn't really move. Like it just, it is just plastic and it just kind of stays. I mean, it's very pretty though. And she looks so cute. Like, look at her. I've just put a plait in her hand. That's great. Look at that. She's holding it now. And honestly, what's the point if you can't like do this with the plait?
Yeah, literally.
Like, we love to see it. She is really pretty. I think like, I like her.
I really like all the eyes. Oh no, why can she do that with her arm? Oh, I can't make her T-pose.
Yeah, 0 out of 10, you can't make a T-pose.
0 out of 10, you can't make a T-pose. Absolutely ridiculous.
So I think in terms of a rating, I'm going to give this one a 3 as well, but for different reasons, because I think she's really pretty. And like she's be like she'll look like I'm excited to like put her on display. I think in terms of like playability, I think there's potential here, but I think that in posability, like she isn't like the Lady Noir figure is not as good as the Cat Noir figure.
Look how short she is in comparison.
Cat Noir is too busy being a part of my tableau, so I can't bring him back. I'm afraid.
2 heroes with the best Kwame. Am I right? I'd give it a 3. The posability is not as good.
She can't T-pose.
Yeah, that is a sin. That
she can't do a lot
T-pose.
Of poses. Her feet don't bend. But she is very pretty and she does smell like nostalgia.
Can we just talk about the fact that it says Mr. Bug, Sir Bug, and then Hair Bug?
Hair Bug. what really gets me about that is obviously like the pun is... Wait, what is the pun?
I don't think there is one. He's just well, because it's Ladybug, but then it's Mr. Bug. It's like, he looks like he's ready to run. He's getting ready to travel.
So we're back to the good posability.
This, maybe it's an Adrian thing. Maybe only Adrian is allowed.
Because he's a model, right?
That's true.
I don't know what this nonsense is. I guess that's
her
yo-yo.
It's a yo-yo. Hang on. Oh. So you can put it in his hand. Oh, I'm not sure about the yo-yo. It's a bit static, isn't it? His head's really not. The yo-yo is gone. My carpet's pink and I don't know where it is.
Are his arms kind of short?
His arms are quite short.
They're quite
right.
Stubby, aren't they? His legs are very posable.
Noir and see.
Wow, gang. I mean, look at this.
Whoa. We don't need marinette. Look at this. This is absolute teen. This kind of looks like he's just abducted her. Not very romantic. Not
there you go. I kind of got it. Yeah.
Oh. Oh, that's good.
See, this just looks like he has just lifted her.
What I will say is that I was struggling to move Mr. Bug's head, and his hair is really spiky. So just look out for that.
But he's very sharp, you're right.
It's really sharp. Like, I think I've actually bruised my thumb a little bit there, gang. Like that is sharp, so don't leave this one on the floor.
Also, you can't T-pose him, which is appalling.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. I think the only one you can T-pose is
Cat Noir.
Cat Noir, and you can T-pose.
Right,
so
can I update my Cat Noir rating to 5 out of 5 for the T-pose?
Yeah, it's like, I didn't realise how much I needed that, but look at...
This is fairly powerful. How did you T-pose yours? Well, he can, however, do it to him. That is the Kwame swap in a nutshell, isn't it? It's just, we had to do it to him.
No, we had to do it to him. I gotta say, I really love the yo-yo. I know you aren't feeling it.
I've lost mine. It's gone on the floor somewhere.
I really love it because it's that sort of like, it's see-through, but it's not shiny. And it reminds me of all the accessories that used to come with Littlest Pet Shops. And I was a big Littlest Pet Shops fan.
POV, your Ladybug and Cat Noir has turned evil for the fifth time that day. Mr. Bug does not have a single thought going on.
Like, he doesn't, but I quite like the complete...
He's astral planing.
I like the lack of thought.
His eyes are completely glazed. He does not know what's going on.
Good moment, that's so threatening. Stop. I'm so threatened by that. I think Mr. Bug gets another 3. All right, I'm going to add these to my tableau in the background.
POV, you're the only one in the Zoom call.
I hate you both so much. Gonna call the RSPCA because Ladybug didn't feed me. have you put him in your hair? Oh, cute.
Oh, he's holding on.
Ow, he's kicking me in the ear.
Alright, so that was our unboxing.
What are you doing in my Zoom call?
Please let me do my outro. So that was our little miraculous toy unboxing. We really enjoyed doing this, and I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, even if it was complete chaos. All the links to these toys are down in the description below. This isn't sponsored. We just wanted to treat ourselves to some fun, miraculous stuff. Do you think this is what Adrian has in his brain? He's got like Ladybug on one shoulder and him as Cat Noir on the other shoulder.
No, oh my God, that's so good.
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Let us know down in the comments if there's any other miraculous merchandise that you think we should have a go at unboxing. I know there's some excellent stuff on the Zag official store that I definitely want to try and get my hands on. But yeah, if you enjoyed this, then make sure to leave us a big thumbs up, subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss anything new. Let us know in the comments what you thought. And Merry Christmas! We'll see you next time!
Bye!
Bye. Momo, what are you doing?
I don't know, I've lost the plot.
I've lost it, I'm lost in the sauce.
A late entry from the Wigsillies.